감사합니다.
Thank you very much.
우리는 어떻게 기도 응답 받냐 이걸 잘 모르고 있습니다.
Now we don't really know how to receive answers to prayer.
기도 응답은 받아야 되는데 실제 어떻게 해서 받냐를 놓치고 있죠.
Now we need to receive answers to prayer, but we don't know how to do that.
오늘은 전 세계 우리 예배를 지금 홍콩에서 드리고 있습니다.
Now right now we're having this global worship here in Hong Kong.
홍콩 빌립에서 여러분이 세계 복음화할 수 있는 응답을 오늘 붙잡아야 되겠습니다.
And so from here in Hong Kong, you must grab hold the answer by which you can do world evangelization.
세 가지 하면 응답을 받을 수 있습니다.
And if you do three things, you can receive that answer. The first.
여러분들이 24 할 수 있는 기도 제목을 잡아야 돼요.
That you have to hold on to the prayer topic that you can pray for 24 hours a day.
저는 한 40년 전부터 똑같은 기도를 했습니다.
That from about 40 years ago, I've been praying the same prayer.
왜 우리 가문이 이렇게도 어렵고 가난하냐?
That why are things so difficult and so poor in my family line?
가문을 살려야 되겠다.
I need to save my family line.
그 기도했습니다.
I prayed that prayer.
왜 내 주위에는 또 우리 아버지는 늘 저렇게 아프냐?
And why is my father and the people around me always so sick?
건강이 뭐며 병든 자를 어떻게 살리느냐? 기도했습니다.
I prayed what is health and how can I save those who are sick?
교회가 왜 전도를 못하냐?
Why is the church unable to evangelize?
세계복음 할 수 있도록 해달라고 하나님께 기도했습니다.
I prayed to God that we could do world evangelization.
이 세 가지가요 응답이 다 왔어요.
But answers came for all three of those prayer topics.
이 응답이요 계속해서 오기 시작하는데 두 번째 게 중요해요.
And those answers continue to come, but the second thing is important.
우리는 위기 왔다 오히려 괜찮습니다. 그렇죠?
Now, when a crisis comes, rather that's good for us.
위기가 오면은 사람들은 오히려 더 하나님 답을 찾아내잖아요.
That when a crisis comes, rather people they look more for God's answers.
위기가 오면은 안 하던 기도한다니까요.
That when a crisis comes, people who
그렇잖아요.
weren't praying before start praying.
근데 문제가 어딨냐?
But where does the problem lie?
위기 때보다 하나님의 축복을 언제 다 놓치는 거니까 우리 속에 있는 작은 갈등입니다.
That rather than those crises, when do we lose hold of all of God's blessings? It's the small conflicts inside of us.
명심해야 돼요.
Keep this in
하나님
mind.
하나님 축복을 다 놓치는 겁니다.
That's when we lose hold of all of God's blessings.
쉬운 예를 들어보겠습니다.
Let me give you a simple
오늘
example.
오늘 11장 19절부터 30절까지 읽었어요.
We read from Acts chapter 11 verse 19 through 30.
무슨 일인지 압니까?
Now, do you know what happened before that?
말도 안 되는 갈등이었나?
That it was a ridiculous conflict.
왜 베드로 사도는 이방인 집에 식사를 했냐?
Why did the apostle Peter go and eat in the home of a pagan?
시비가 일어난 거예요.
And so people began to criticize that.
말 됩니까?
Does that make any sense?
이렇게 우리는요, 복음 제대로 못 깨닫고 복음 다 받아놓고도 못 누리는 이렇게 돼요.
In this way, we lose hold of the gospel. Even though we receive the gospel, we can't enjoy it, and we lose hold of everything.
자꾸 그래도 옛날 생각 가지고.
But still, we go back to our old way of thinking.
왜냐, 이스라엘 사람들은 법이 그랬거든요. 이방인 집에 가지 마. 뭐 이렇게 있을 말. 그걸 얘기 또 하는 거예요.
The Israelites, they had a law. Oh, you should not go and eat in the home of a Gentile. That's what they were talking about.
예수님께서 약속하신 것이 이루어졌구나. 이리 될 거 아니에요.
They should rather have said, oh, what Jesus spoke about has been fulfilled.
왜 이방인의 집에 가서 식사를 하고 그렇게 했냐?
But why did you go to the home of a Gentile and eat with him?
말도 안 되는 소리를 세계 교회는 하고 있습니다.
And so the world churches are 그렇죠. saying ridiculous things right now.
조심해야 돼. 그것만 이기부려 응답 와요.
We have to be careful. And if we just overcome that, then 그렇죠. we will receive answers. Isn't that so?
그래서 세 번째 행기 뭡니까?
So what's the third thing they did?
안디옥 교회는 완전히 망대를 바꿔버렸어요.
The Antioch church completely changed the partisan.
그럼 응답 옵니다.
Then answers come.
여러분이 진짜 24 기도 시작하면요. 건강도 회복되고 다 회복돼.
If you really begin 24-hour prayer, you have the restoration of your health, the restoration of everything.
진짜 작은 갈등 있잖아요. 그게 축복 다 있는데 그것 때문에 우리는 다 놓치는 거예요.
At the small conflicts, all the blessings lie there, but we lose hold of all of them because of those conflicts.
사소한 거잖아요. 그것 때문에 축복을 다 놓치면 되겠습니까?
That we shouldn't lose hold of all our blessings because of the petty things.
여러분에게 있는 갈등 속에는 엄청난 것이 들어있다는 걸 아셔야 돼요.
You have to realize the fact that within your small internal
그렇죠?
conflicts are all the blessings.
요셉에게 일어나는 가정 문제 갈등은 요셉을 세계 총리로 만드는 길이었어요.
The conflicts as well as a family problem that Joseph faced, that became the very path to make Joseph into a world governor.
계속 다윗을 괴롭히는 사울 왕은요, 다윗에게 세계를 움직이는 사람으로 만들어졌어요.
That King Saul who continued to torment David, that enabled David to become a leader who moved the world.
조심해야 됩니다.
So be careful.
지금 세계복음 안 되는 이유가 그것 때문에 안 된다.
And so it's that very reason that prevents us from doing world evangelization right now.
조용한 거, 복음도 아닌 거. 이거 시간 다 보내요.
The petty little things inside of the church, the things that are not even the gospel, we waste all our time on that. Then we are fools.
이 교회는 그런 실수하지 말고요. 세계복음하는 교회로 서시기를 주 예수 이름으로 축복합니다.
May this church not commit that mistake, but may you stand as a church that does world evangelization in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And change the partisan.
어떻게 바꿨냐?
How?
이 중요하죠.
This is what's important.
스데반의 환난을 인하여 흩어진 자들이 그랬어요.
It's as those who have been scattered by the persecution in connection with Stephen. It's those people who gathered.
뭡니까?
What is this?
전혀 핍박을 두려워하지 않아요.
They did not fear persecution at all.
그렇죠.
Isn't that so?
우리는 때문에가 아닙니다.
It's not because of this.
새 청년은 뭐라고 말했냐? 우리가 불 가운데 들어가면 하나님이 건져 주시지 아니하실지라도.
What did the three young men say? Even if we go into the fire, even if the Lord does not save us.
그게 우리의 신앙입니다.
That is our faith.
아유, 그럼 죽으면 어떡하지? 그거 아닙니다.
Oh, what's going to happen if we die? It wasn't that.
이사야 이제 다니엘은 감사하면서 기도했대.
Daniel prayed in thanksgiving, even in the face of death.
에스더는 죽으면 죽겠다고 했어.
And Esther said, "If I perish, I perish."
이 안디옥이 그런 교회였어요.
And this Antioch church was that kind of church.
핍박이 일어나서 환난에 흩어졌단 말이오. 그 사람들이 모여서 세운 교회가 안디옥이에요.
Persecution and tribulation arose, and so they scattered. But it's those people who gathered in Antioch.
어떤 망대를 바꿨냐?
And so what partisan did they change?
26절에 중요한 말이 나와.
Verse 26 is something very important.
비로소 사람들이 그리스도인이라 칭하였더라 그랬어요.
The disciples were called Christians first at Antioch.
뭡니까?
What is that?
그리스도 올바로 아는 교회.
They were the church that correctly knew Christ.
그리스도가 무슨 말인지 아는 거예요.
They knew what Christ meant.
이 망대를 세우고요.
And so they raised this partisan.
흑암이 막 무너지는 겁니다.
That's why the force of darkness began to crumble.
여러분 진짜 그리스도 알고 누리면 흑암은 무너지게 되었습니다. 아무 걱정 안 하셔도 돼요.
If you really know and enjoy Christ, the force of darkness will crumble. So there's no reason to worry.
그리고 어땠습니까?
And then what else?
역사상 처음으로 바울이라는 인물을 불러와서요. 선교사 파송을 했고요.
For the very first time in history, they brought in a person named Paul and sent him out as a missionary.
대단한 진짜 역사입니다.
That truly is amazing.
교인들이 이상해요. 바울을 데리고 오니까요. 막 싫어하는 사람도 있어.
Church members are very strange. When they brought in Paul, there were some believers who church members who didn't like that.
저 사람 옛날에 핍박자 아니냐?
Oh, wasn't he a persecutor in the past?
저 사람 옛날에 예수 믿는 사람 괴롭힌 사람 아니냐?
That he's someone who used to torment people who believed in Jesus.
무슨 상관이세요?
But what does that matter?
그리스도로 돌아왔는데.
That he came to know Christ and came back to the Lord.
그 사람은 누가 찾아간다는가? 바나바가 찾으러 왔어.
But who went looking for him? Barnabas.
그리고 이 바나바를 데리고 온 겁니다.
And so Barnabas brought Paul back.
거기서 초대교회에 있었던 모든 역사를 설명했어.
And there he explained all the works that arose in the early church.
이래서 지구 선교 처음으로 선교사 파송을.
That's why for the first time since the creation of this world, they were sent out as missionaries.
놀라운 일이지.
That's amazing.
서론의 세 개 얘기한 거 기억하셔야 됩니다.
So remember the three things that I spoke about in the introduction.
그 세 개 기억하면요. 아무리 꿈이다 미래 소용없어 24 하는 데는 못 말려.
If you keep that in mind, then remember, no matter how much people talk about their dreams, people who are doing something 24 hours cannot be stopped.
24 기도한다는 그 말은요. 밥도 안 먹고 기도만 한단 말이 아니잖아요.
That when I say you're praying 24 hours a day, it doesn't mean that you're always praying, you're not even eating.
눈 뜨면 그리스도께서 주신 것 기도하세요.
That when you open your eyes, pray with what Christ gave you.
예, 다른 것에서 응답이 안 와요.
And so it's because we do something else that answers do not come.
약속 드릴 수 있어요.
I can promise you.
눈 감기 전에 그리스도께서 주신 것 기도하라.
Before you close your eyes at night, pray with what Christ gave you.
예수님 하라고는 안 하고 맨날 이거 달라 저거 달라. 그러지도 아니고 말아 맨날 왜.
Instead of doing what Jesus tells us, we're always asking for this and asking for that. We're not beggars.
이제 여러분 바르게 하셔야 돼요. 예수님이 직접 말씀하셨어요.
Now we need to do things properly. Jesus directly said.
너희는 이런 거 달라, 저런 거 달라 그렇게 기도하지 말라고 했어요.
I don't pray this way, asking for this and asking for that.
너희 아버지 하나님께서 다 아시느니라.
That your Father God in heaven already knows.
너희는 그 먼저 주의 나라와 그의 의를 구하라.
But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness.
그리하면 모든 것 다 해주시.
Then all these things will be given to you as well.
그리고는 마지막 날 모여서 40일 동안 하나님 나라 일을
설명. And on the last days he gathered together and explained God's kingdom for 40 days.
저는 그걸 계속 기도하다가요. 일곱 망대 여정 이정표 찾아냈어요.
And as I continued to pray with that, I was able to find the seven partisans, journeys and guideposts. So try this.
그러면 반드시 역사를 나게.
Then absolutely the works will arise.
그래서 비로소 그리스도의 일컬음 받아들만 이 사람들하고, 야, 이 사람들 진짜 그리스도인이구나.
And so they were called Christians first there. People looked at them and said, wow, these are real Christians.
이렇게 망대를 바꿔버려.
In this way, they changed the partisan.
오늘 여러분이 모든 메시지 듣는 분들이 시작하시길 바랍니다.
Today, may all of you listen to the message. Start this.
아무 힘 없는 여자 요게벳이 망대를 바꿔버렸어요.
One powerless woman, Jochebed, 그렇죠? she changed her partisan.
놀라운 일입니다.
And it's an amazing thing.
아이들이 다 죽게 됐잖아요. 근데 모세도 죽게 됐단 말이죠.
All the children were dying, and even Moses was about to be killed.
이 요게벳이 여러분 잘 아시지 않습니까?
But this Jochebed, as you well know,
모세를 왕궁으로 보내야 되겠다.
She said, "I need to send Moses to the palace."
대단하죠.
That's really something. The average person could not even dream of that.
자세히 보세요.
But look carefully.
왕궁으로 보내야만 됩니다.
She had to send it to the palace.
겁니다.
That's what she knew.
안 그러면 딴 데 살 수가 없어.
If not, he could not survive anywhere else.
왕궁으로 보내야 애급 그걸 바꿀 수 있어.
That she had to send him into the palace to change Egypt. And so, how accurately did she see?
겁니다.
This is what happens.
여러분이 확실한 망대를 세워라.
You have to raise your sure partisan.
그러면 하나님의 역사는 시작되게 돼 있어.
Then God's works are bound to begin.
뭐 특별한 거를 비결을 찾아낸 게 아니라니까요.
Then we're not looking for something special, some key to success.
모세를 왕궁으로 보내지 아니하면 절대 애굽을 살릴 수가 없어요.
That if you do not send Moses a palace, you cannot save Egypt.
그게 하나님의 절대 망대를 세우고.
And that's what it means to raise God's absolute partisan.
그뿐만 아닙니다.
Not only that.
라합 같은 사람.
People like Rahab.
정탐꾼을 숨겨주고 그 사람은 어떤 응답을 받았습니까?
That she hid the spies, and what kind of answer did she receive?
아니, 정탐꾼을 숨겨주고 자기가 무슨 하나님 축복을 받고 이 말이 아닙니다.
Then
뭡니까?
She didn't hide the spies in order to get God's blessings. What is this?
절대로 죽어서는 안 된다는 사람 그 사람을 알은 거예요.
That she recognized that there are people 그렇죠? that could not be put to death.
그런 일을 하셔야 돼요.
That's the kind of things that you need to do.
이 사람들은 여호와를 설명해야 되는 정탐꾼들입니다.
These are the scouts that needed to explain the Lord God.
이 사람들은 출애굽해서 가나안 땅으로 가야 돼요.
These are the people that had Exodus and needed to go into Canaan.
이걸 깨달은 겁니다.
That's what she realized and that's what she said to them.
나중에 다윗의 할머니가 됩니다.
Later on, she becomes David's grandmother.
엄청나죠.
It's amazing,
여러분,
isn't it?
망대를 제대로 딱 세우고.
And so properly raise the partisan.
빨리 안 나오면 급하게 할 거 없어. 기도하면 나올 때까지 기도하면 돼요.
And if you don't find it quickly, there's no reason
그렇지만,
to rush it. Just pray until it comes
여러분이
out.
여러분이 아무리 연약해도 하나님이 가장 원하시는 망대를 세워버리면 그때부터 모든 응답은 시작됩니다.
No matter how weak you may be, if you raise the absolute that God truly desires, that's when all the answers begin.
뭐 돈 없다, 다 거짓말이야.
I have no money, that's all a lie.
은행 가면 꽉 있어요.
The banks are full of money.
능력이 없지, 얼마든지 있어요.
That you don't have the capability to wield it. What's the problem?
전도 안 된다, 거짓말이야.
Evangelism is not taking place, that's a lie.
중요한 망대만 세워버리면 다 살아나.
If you raise the important partisan, everything will be revived.
이제 시간표입니다.
Now is the time.
왜 이 메시지를 지금 세계가 예배드린 예배를 왜 지금 홍콩 와서 드리고 있나 이 말이에요.
Then why are we giving this 그렇죠? message, this worship that the entire world is getting together? Why are we doing it right now here in Hong Kong?
여기는 여러분이 진짜 하나님의 축복 언약을 붙잡아라.
That here you have the truly grab hold of God's grace and blessings.
그래서 성경을 자세히 보세요.
So look carefully at the Bible.
홍해 앞에서.
In front of the Red Sea.
근데 더 중요한 건 뭡니까?
But what's more important than that?
하나님이 모세에게 80대인데 불렀어요.
That God called Moses at the age of 80.
내 백성을 데리고 나가서 피 제사 드리라.
Go and take my people out to offer a blood
알아들었어요.
sacrifice. He understood.
어머니에게 들었던 얘기.
Because he heard it from his mother.
물을 필요도 없어.
No reason to even ask.
근데 저는 못 갑니다. 그래서.
But he said, but I can't go.
지금 내가 잡아 죽이려고 하는데. 가면 바로 죽습니다.
That if I go back there, I'm a wanted man. They're going to arrest me and kill me.
나 나이도 많습니다.
And I'm too old.
그리고 지금 백성들 내 말이 이제 안 듣습니다.
And the people, they won't listen to me.
여호와께서 보냈다고 해라.
Tell them that the Lord sent you.
나는 여호와니라.
It says, I am the Lord.
능한 손으로 너와 함께.
I'll be with me, with you, with my mighty arm.
열 가지 기적으로 나왔잖아요.
And so they 그렇죠? came out with the 10 miracles. Isn't that so?
기적이 아닙니다. 당연히 일어날 일이 일어났어요.
But those are not miracles. Those are things that rightfully should take place.
그래 나왔는데 홍해를 만났잖아요.
And they came out that way, but they're 그렇죠? facing the Red Sea. Isn't that so?
당연히 건너야 됩니다.
They should rightfully cross.
많은 사람이 원망해서 왜 우리를 이까지 죽게 만드느냐.
But many people resented him saying, why did you bring us this far so that we could all die here?
그때 모세가 가만히 서서 여호와께서 행하시는 구원을 보라.
But at that time, Moses says, "Stand still and see the salvation the Lord will work for you today."
말하면 안 돼요.
The people should not say that.
우리가 홍해에 빠져 죽는 한이 있더라도 가야 된다라고 해요.
They should have said, "Even if 그렇죠? we drown in the Red Sea, we still need to go."
이게 올바른 믿음이에요.
That's proper faith.
우리는 후대를 위해서 가야 된다.
For the sake of our next generation, we must go.
오늘 못 가겠다 돌아가자.
But they're saying, "Oh no, we can't go. Let's go back to Egypt."
말도 안 되는 소리. 애굽으로 다시 돌아가자.
That's ridiculous. Let's go back to Egypt.
말대.
Does that make any
그래,
sense?
그 사람들 모래 땅에서 다 죽은 거예요.
That's why all those people died in the sand.
그렇죠. 새로 태어난 사람들이 다.
It's the children who were newly born that went into Canaan.
그 앞에 태어난 사람 세 명밖에 못 들어갔어요.
And the people from the first generation,
누굽니까?
only three of them went in. Who were they?
여호수아, 갈렙, 기생나.
It was Joshua, Caleb, and the prostitute Rahab. The rest of them, they could not go in.
명심하셔야 돼요.
Keep that in mind.
하나님이 사실상 초대를 마가다락방에서 안디옥을 옮겨버려.
And so honestly, God moved 그렇잖아요. the lampstand from Mark's upper room to the Antioch church.
얼마나 중요하고 얼마나 무서운 일인지 몰라.
That that's such an important, but also a very scary thing. That's why you must hold firmly to the covenant.
걱정하지 마시고.
Do not worry.
내 능력 걱정하지 마시고.
Do not worry about your power.
하나님이 역사하시면 이상한 일이 벌어집니다.
If God works, then amazing 그렇죠? things happen. Isn't that so?
하나님이 이 교회 역사하시면 이상한 일이 벌어진다.
If God begins to work on this church, uncanny things will happen. No one will be able to stop that.
너무 감사한 일이에요.
And so it's something to be so thankful for.
좋은 렘넌트 너무 많고.
There are so many great remnants here.
그러게 오늘 와서 일부러 장로님 몇 분인가 물어봐서 장로님들께 너무 감사해. 이런 분들이 있으니까요. 이런 지금 후대들이 일어나는 거예요.
I come here as I was speak with a few of the elders and I'm so thankful. It's because of these kinds of elders exist that we've got the next generation arising like this.
얼마나 감사한지 몰라요.
It's something to be so thankful for.
너무 많아.
There are so many great remnants here.
그리고 가보니까 이 또 홍콩이 여러 가지로 뭐 보통 나라가 아니에요 보니까.
And I look carefully, and with all of your conditions, Hong Kong is not your average nation.
난 어제 처음 들었네 뭐.
Then I heard this for the very first time yesterday.
홍콩은 상속세도 없습니다.
They said that there is no tax for inheritance here in Hong Kong.
그래서 더 오겠네 내려.
And I said that means that all the rich people are going to come here.
여러분 회사를 자녀에게 주는데 40% 50% 뺏어가 버리면 회사 망하는 거예요 사실은.
I think about it. 그렇죠? If a president of a company passes that company on to the next son and they have to pay like billions of dollars in taxes, that's ruining that company.
없어 있구나.
And I realize Hong Kong truly is on the cutting edge.
뭐 세계보고만이 딱 좋은 나라예요.
That it's perfect for doing world evangelization.
어지간하면 이사 가지 말고.
And so if you possibly can, don't move anywhere else and stay here.
너무 세계보고.
Why? Because it's such a good place for world evangelization.
망대를 세워라.
Raise the bartism.
그렇죠.
Isn't that so?
그러니 사드락 메사가 빈누고 다니엘 에스더가 다 큰 일을 한 게 아닙니다.
That's why Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, Daniel, Esther, they didn't do great things.
진짜 망대를 세웠어요.
They raised the real partisan.
이 안디옥 교회가 기가 차지어 버렸어요. 세계 선교 문을 열고 바울을 데리고 왔다니까.
This Antioch church, it really is amazing. They opened a door to world missions and they brought in Paul.
흩어진 자들이 그랬습니다.
It's as those who had been scattered.
첫째입니다.
That's the first thing.
완전히 운명을 바꾸는 모임이었습니다.
That it was a meeting that completely changed their fate.
운명을 바꾸는 망대를 세우라.
And so raise the partisan 그렇죠? that changes your fate.
내 운명을 바꿔버리는 망대를 세워야 돼.
That you have to raise the partisan that changes your fate.
나는 응답 못 받은 사람 안타까워요. 뭐 때문에 응답 못 받은 하나님 자녀인데.
That when I see people who don't receive answers, it's really frustrating. Why are they not receiving answers? They're God's children.
맨날 율법설이 허술해 나오고 있고. 그 보소. 어떻게 베드로를 뭐 그렇게 말을 합니까?
They're always saying ridiculous
아,
things.
이래 될 건데.
They're always saying ridiculous things, always going back to the law. How could they say it to Peter? They should rather be thankful to him.
이게 뭡니까?
But what is this?
세계 선교 문을 여는 시간표예요.
It was a time schedule to open the doors to world missions.
완전히 운명을 뒤바꾸는 망대.
That it was the bar that completely overturned their fate.
뭐라고 돼 있습니까?
What else does it say?
스데반의 환난으로 인하여 흩어진 자들이.
It says those who were scattered in connection with the persecution that arose over Stephen.
스데반이 어떤 일을 했습니까?
And so what did Stephen do?
메시지 하나 하고 죽었어요.
He just gave one message and died.
여러분, 전도자는 죽는 게 아닙니다.
Evangelists, they don't die.
성경은 잔이라 이랬어요.
The Bible says he fell asleep.
여러분, 핍박하는 핍박 아닙니다. 시작입니다.
The persecution you face, that's 그렇죠? not persecution. That's the beginning.
불신자들이 말을 끝냈다는 건 우리는 아직 시작도 아닌 거예요.
The unbelievers say, oh, it's the end for you. But for us, we haven't even started yet.
스데반이 죽는 줄 알면서 모든 역사를 다 얘기해서 핍박, 너희들 언제든지 선지자를 핍박하지 않았냐 하는 얘기를 쫙 다 했는데.
Knowing that he would die, Stephen began to talk about every example of how the persecution persecuted all of the prophets, knowing that he could be killed.
그래서 그렇게 말하면 죽어요.
That if you speak that way there, they would put you to death.
전부 들고 좀 돌려가지고 스데반을 죽인 거예요.
That's why they all took up stones and they stoned Stephen to death.
그 장소 어떤 장소인가 하니까요. 네 전도하기 때문에 죽인다 이 장소가 아니고 지금 말해봐. 네 이 말 듣고 네 말 들어보고 오늘 너를 죽이든지 살리든지 하는 날이다.
And so they weren't going to kill him because he evangelized. He was actually standing on trial. They're saying, right now, right here, tell us what you believe, and if we don't think it's right, then you'll be put to death.
지금 그거 처형장입니다.
So simply put, it was an execution.
마지막 말 들어보고 서대바 너를 죽이든지 용서든지 둘 중 하나.
Let's hear your last words, and either we will put you to death or we will forgive you.
그게 증인으로 바울이 있었잖아요.
And Paul was standing there 그렇죠. as a witness.
그 현장입니다.
It was that kind of feeling.
서대만 거침없이 얘기했어요.
And without hesitation, Stephen said.
당연히 그 사람 돌로 때려 죽이잖아요.
And so rightfully, those people took up their stones and killed him.
그때 하늘 문이 열렸다.
But at that time, the doors to heaven
예수님께서
opened.
우편에 서 계셨다고.
And Jesus stood at the right hand of God.
그 교회입니다.
It's that church.
완전히 세계 망대를 뒤바꾸는 운명을 바꾸는 망대를 세웠다.
They raised the partisan that really changed the world partisan that changed their fate.
서대반은 잔이라 그랬어.
And it says Stephen fell asleep.
이때 등장한 인물이 서대반 죽일 때 증인으로 서 있던 바울이 그리스도를 만난 거예요.
And the individual appeared at that time. This Saul, who was standing as a witness during Stephen's death, he stands as a witness.
완전히 그냥 세계 운명을 바꾸는 시간.
And so he's called by God, and that really changed the world.
그 바울이 여러분 어떤 일이 벌어졌습니까?
And what happened through that Paul?
보통 사람을 통해 전도하는데 바울은 얼마만큼 악하고 강했나면은 바로 그래서 위에 빛을 내리 비쳤잖아요.
And so think about it. Most people they get evangelized through other people, but can you imagine how wicked Paul was that God would directly shine His light down on him from heaven?
그랬는데. 사울아 사울아 부르니까요.
That he passed out but he heard a voice calling him Saul Saul.
집에서 부르는 이름이 사울이라. 이 바울이 주여 누구십니까?
Saul was his original name and so then Saul answers Lord who are you?
나는 예수를 안 그러고요. 나는 네가 핍박하는 예수이라.
And he didn't say I am Jesus. He says I am Jesus whom you are persecuting. But who did he persecute? He killed Stephen.
완전히 바울이 그것이 무릎 꿇고.
And there Paul completely got on his knees.
이거요, 이 전도자로 바뀌고.
And so he changes into an evangelist.
이런 일이 벌어진 겁니다.
These are the things that happen.
운명을 뒤바꾸는 망대를 세워라.
Yet the raise the partisan that overturns your fate.
두 번째입니다.
Then number two.
재앙 막는 망대를 세우라.
Yeah, the raise the partisan that blocks disaster.
그렇죠?
Isn't that so?
이스라엘은 곧 재앙이 맙니다.
Israel was on the brink of destruction.
이거 막을 수 있는 망대를 세우라.
That you have to raise the partisan that blocks this.
처참하게 망합니다. 70년에 이스라엘 무너집니다.
They would pitifully perish. We saw that in 70 years Israel would fall.
후대들이 밖에 나와서 어마어마하게 죽었어.
And their descendants would be killed out in the world.
나는 그중에 제일 비참한 게 뭐냐? 아이들.
And the most pitiful of all that were the children.
아이들 살아있는 거를요 생체 실험했다니까.
That these living children, they did live experiments on those children.
어른 죽었다 뭐 그건 또 뭐 그렇다 손치고.
An adult died. Yes, that is sad.
복음 안전하는 제사장이 죽었다 뭐 그건 뭐 때문에 잘 죽은 거고.
That a priest who's not proclaimed the gospel has been put to death. Maybe that's a good thing.
아이들.
But the children.
이래가지고요 그 장면 보면서 야 창고에 같은데 모아놓고. 얘들은 지금 얘를 불도록 기다리고 있는 거예요.
Looking at those scenes, we saw the kids. They were put in these storehouses, and they're trembling in fear, awaiting their fate.
그런 비참한 일을 당해서.
That's the kind of pathetic death that they all faced.
그래서 이거 막는 길이 그리스도인데 이 망대를 세워라.
And the way to block this is Christ. So raise that partisan.
곧 로마는 멸망돼.
In a short while, 그렇죠. Rome would be destroyed. Isn't that so?
되기 전에 빨리 망대를 세워 로마 복음을 해라.
Before that happens, quickly raise the partisan and do Rome evangelization.
이스라엘 흩어지기 전에 빨리
Before Israel is scattered, quickly spread the gospel.
이 망대를 말하는 거예요.
I'm talking about this partisan.
운명을 뒤바꾸는 망대요. 재앙을 막는 망대를 세우라.
That raise the partisan that overturns your fate. Raise the partisan that blocks disaster.
더 중요한 게 뭡니까?
What's more important?
후대 살리는 망대를 세워.
Raise the partisan to save the next generation.
그래서 회당에 들어간 겁니다.
That's why he went into the synagogue.
회당에 들어가서 예수 믿으라 그렇게 말 안 했어요.
And going into the synagogue, he didn't just say, "Oh, believe in Jesus."
재앙이 왜 올까요?
Why does disaster come?
왜 영적 문제 올까요?
Why do spiritual problems come?
왜 사단에게 당할까요?
Why are we being taken in by Satan?
왜 지옥 배경 살까요?
Why are we living underneath the background of
그
hell?
그 핵이라는 단어가 그리스도예요.
And the word that resolves all that is 그렇죠? Christ. Isn't that so?
그럼 그리스도는 누굽니까?
Then who is this Christ?
그래서 예수 믿는 거예요.
That's why we believe in Jesus.
그러니까 그 설명을 고린도 데살로니가에서 했단 말이에요.
And so that's the explanation he gave in Thessalonica.
그리스도께서 십자가에 죽어야 될 것과 부활해야 될 걸 설명해 달라.
He explained why Christ had to die on the cross and why he must resurrect.
그래야 그리스도니까.
Only then can he be the Christ.
성경에 약속된 거니까.
It's promised in the Bible.
엄청난 거죠.
It's amazing.
그다음에 안식일마다 회당에 들어갔다 했죠.
And then it says every Sabbath he went into the synagogue. What does that mean?
우리 후대들이 복음 바로 알고 기도할 수 있도록 만들면 어디서든지 성공하는 거예요.
If we make our children correctly know the gospel and be able to pray, they'll be able to succeed and have victory anywhere.
우리 렘넌트들이 복음 누리는 기도를 할 수 있다면 어디에 있어도 괜찮아요.
If our remnants can have the prayer of enjoying the gospel, it doesn't matter where they are.
여러분의 후대들이 기도할 수 있다면 무슨 일을 만나도 괜찮아요.
If your posterity knows how to pray, it doesn't matter what they face.
그걸 가르친 거예요.
That's what he taught.
그리고 또 뭡니까?
And what else?
진짜 응답이 뭔가를 가르쳐야 돼요.
He taught what real answers were.
19장 8절에.
That's chapter 19, verse 8.
바울이 예수님 말씀한 그대로 해서요. 담대히 하나님 나라에 대하여 석 달 동안 설명해 돼요.
Then Paul did exactly what Jesus did. He boldly spoke about God's kingdom for three months.
응답입니다.
That is the answer.
그러니까 틀리게 가르치면 안 돼요. 바르게 가르쳐.
So don't teach it incorrectly. Teach it accurately.
그렇죠.
Isn't that so?
그리스도 틀리게 하면 안 되잖아요.
That we can't know Christ incorrectly.
예레미야 같답니다.
Oh, he's like Jeremiah.
세례요한 같다.
Or John the Baptist.
어? 엘리야 같다.
Or like Elijah.
선지자 같다고 합니다.
Or like one of the prophets.
이런 식으로 아니까 안 되는 거예요.
But because they only know Jesus that way, it's not working.
주는 그리스도시요. 살아계신 하나님의 아들이시요.
You are the Christ, the Son of the living God.
창세기 3장 15절 그분이시요 살아계신 하나님.
That you are the one from Genesis 3 verse 15 and the Son of the living God. Those are tremendous words.
양의 피 받는 날 다 해방돼 나왔어요. 그분이시요 살아계신 하나님.
The day they put on the lamb's blood, they all were set free. You are that Christ and the Son of the living God.
포로에서 돌아온 길 없어요. 처녀가 잉태의 아들을 낳을 것이 그 이름이 임마누엘이라.
There's no way to come back from captivity, but a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and his name shall be called Emmanuel.
그분이시요 살아계신 하나님의 아들이십니다라고 고백한 거예요.
You are that person, and you are the Son of the living God. That was his confession.
아, 요나 시므나 네가 머리가 좋구나 안 그랬어요.
That God did not say, Simon, son of Jonah, you're so smart.
But
it's not going to work with your smartness or your brains.
네가 복이 있구나.
You are blessed.
이걸 알게 하는 하늘에 계신 내 아버지시니.
Because the one who allowed you to notice is my Father in heaven.
너는 베드로라. 이 반석 위에 내 교회를 내가 직접 세우겠다.
And you are Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church.
원문을 그렇게 돼 있어요.
That's what it says in the original manuscript.
세웠다.
I will build my church.
음부의 권세 너를 이기지 못할 것이다.
And the gates of Hades will not overcome you.
내가 네게 천국 열쇠를 주라.
And I give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven.
엄청나죠?
It's amazing, isn't it?
이 축복을 베드로가 받은 거예요.
This is the blessing Peter received.
그러니까 이 교회가 말이죠. 완전히 재앙 막는 망대를 쌓아.
And so this church completely raised the partisan to block the disaster.
그리고 후대 막는 망대를 쌓아.
And also the partisan to raise the next generation.
세 가지입니다.
It's those three things.
응답하는 조건 서론에서 얘기했고요. 여러분 어떤 망대를 세워야 되느냐? 운명을 뒤바꾸는 망대.
That we had the three conditions by which we receive answers, and then what kind of partisan must you raise?
그렇죠.
The partisan that changes your fate.
그리고 재앙 막아야 돼요, 세계 재앙을.
And
we must block
disasters, world disasters. Raise that partisan.
그리고 이제 문제는 후대예요. 후대들 앞으로 어떻게 되겠습니까?
And the issue is our next generation. What's going to happen to them in the future?
30%씩 정신병자 아이들에게 걱정하고 있어요.
That right now we see a rapid increase in mental illness, 30% among the young children.
그 살리는 망대 세워라.
That raise the partisan to save them.
역사는 할 수밖에 없죠.
The works are bound to take place then.
어느 정도 응답했습니까?
And to what extent did God answer?
천하가 기근 들었는데 안디옥 교회만 경제 축복을 하시.
It says the entire world was facing a famine, but the Antioch church alone received financial blessings. What is that?
빛의 경제.
It's the economy of light.
선교 경제.
The economy of missions.
렘넌트 경제.
And the economy of the remnant. They restored that.
당연히.
Rightfully.
아무 걱정하지 말고 그냥 24 기도하세요.
So don't worry at all. Just pray 24 hours a day.
24 기도하세요. 눈 뜨면 하시고 잠자기 전에 하고.
And 24,
일 생기면 기도하고요.
24 hours isn't anything else. Pray when you wake up in the morning. Pray before you go to sleep at night. And whenever you face something, just pray.
오늘은 우리 어린이 주일이기도 합니다.
Today is also Children's Day.
어린이에게는 뭘 가르쳐야 될까요?
Then what must we teach the children?
교회에서 꼭 해야 됩니다.
You must do this in the church.
기도가 뭔지 가르치면 어릴 때 빨리 달란트가 발견됩니다.
If you teach them what prayer is and while they are young, early on they can realize what their talent is.
안 그러면요. 대학 졸업했는데 달란트 안 나와가지고요.
If not, then we see some kids who graduate from college and they still haven't found their talent. Does that make any sense?
유대인들 10대 때 다 찾아내가지고 세계 보고 저장하고 가잖아요.
And the Jewish people, they find all the kids' talents at the age of 13, and that's how they're able to conquer the world.
그리고 렘넌트에게 세계 복음을 힘을 길러줘야 돼.
And also help our remnants to build up their strength to do world evangelization.
뭐
What does that mean?
영세전에 감추어두었던 것을 알려줘야 돼.
Let them know what was hidden from long ages.
그게 중요한 겁니다.
That's what's important.
그리고 렘넌트들이 미래망대 세우도록 도와줘야 돼.
And help our remnants raise their future partisans.
필수입니다.
It's absolutely essential.
여러분 언약 잡으시길 바랍니다.
And so may you hold to the covenant.
아까 내가 그런 얘기했어요.
And I said earlier today.
제가 전도사 때인데 한 중학생쯤 보이는 여학생이 교회로 왔다가 앉아있다가 가고 가고 이래요.
Then when I was an assistant pastor, there was this young girl, probably a junior high school student, who would come and worship and then leave and then come and then leave.
이상하다. 어디로 말든지 와서 잠깐 한데 가고 간다니까.
Then it's not that she doesn't show up. She always shows up, but she only stays for a moment and then leaves.
한 번 넣어보고. 여러분 접은 걸 탁 줘요.
And one day she gave me a folded piece of paper.
그럼 가는 거예요.
And then she left.
피해 보니까 11조.
And when I opened it up, it was her tithe.
그 나보고 대신 내달라 이 말이지.
And what that meant is that she wanted her, me to do it instead of her.
이상하다.
And I said, this is strange.
물어보고서 와쫙쫙 가니까.
That she kept on coming for a brief moment and then leaving.
어느 날 보니까요. 완전 예배를 드리는 거예요.
But one day she was sitting in the back giving worship.
그래 너무 내 노래 옆 가 보니까요 이제 울어.
And I was really surprised, so I sat next to her, and she was crying.
왜 오늘 이렇게 예배 드린 게 너무 행복했어.
And I asked her, why are you crying? She said, it's such a joy to be able to worship.
야, 니가 그 다른 날은 그냥 가나 안 물었더니.
And I asked her, why did you just leave on the other days?
부모님이 한목이 다 돌아가시대.
It says her both her parents died on the same day.
자기가 동생들 키워야 되는데 돈을 버린다.
And she has to raise her siblings. That's why she has to earn money.
그 교회가 성동교회인데 성동교회 앞에 버스 모인 데 있어요.
Now that was a Seongdong church, and right in front of the Seongdong church, there was a bus depot.
그게 좀 걸려요 오는데, 그런데 거기서 청소한다는 거예요.
And it took some time for her to get to the church from that depot, but 그렇지. she was just cleaning the terminal.
휴일날도 일해야 되기 때문에 자기가 화장실 간다고 쫓아와서 교회 잠깐 왔다 간다는 거예요.
And so she has to work on Sundays as well. So she just tells her boss that she has to go to the bathroom, runs the church, sits for a moment, and then leaves back to work.
오늘은 쉬는 날이라는 거예요.
But that was her day of rest.
야. 나는 여러 가지를 생각했어요.
And so it made me think about many different things.
미안하더라고요.
I felt really bad.
나는 예배 기한 줄도 모르고.
Because I didn't know how precious worship was.
진짜 그래요. 나는 전도사니까 예배 기한 줄을 모르고.
And as an assistant pastor, I didn't know how precious worship was.
뭐 한 번 얻어맞은 것 같아.
But I felt like somebody had hit me on the head.
야, 얘가 말이요. 그렇게 예배 드리고 싶어가지고.
That she wanted to worship 얘가. so badly. She's just a little kid.
너무나 반성했어요.
And so it really made me reflect on myself.
이 귀중한 예배 시간에 나는 그것도 가치도 모르고.
And this precious worship time, I didn't even know how valuable this is.
여러분이 예배와 기도 회복하는 축복이 있게 되기를 예수 그리스도 이름으로 축복합니다.
May you have the blessing to restore worship and prayer in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Let us pray. 감사드립니다.
Father God, thank you.
정말 하나님이 원하시는 망대를 세우게 하옵소서.
Help us to truly raise the partisan that you desire.
나의 인생 망대 세우게 해 주옵소서.
May we raise up our life partisan.
그리스도께서 주신 것을 세우게 해 주옵소서.
May you raise what Christ gave.
주 예수 그리스도 이름으로 기도하옵나이다.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.